everyone, what's going on? Thanks for tuning back into Relevant Jukebox. And today I'm back with another update in my vinyl series where I go over my entire collection, 10 random records at a time. So if you are new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button and like if you like. And if you are already subscribed, thank you. And if you've seen these videos before, I'm basically just gonna hop right into 10 random records here for you guys. Starting off with Animal Collective's Fall Be Kind. This might be, or probably my favorite Animal Collective EP. This is a fun one. Yeah, just, you know, pretty standard pressing over here. Nothing too crazy if I recall. I think it's just like a standard one. Yeah, it's really thick pressing. It feels like 180 gram. It's standard black. I like the labeling on this one. It looks kind of like the moon. But yeah, this is a really cool Animal Collective EP that kind of fit, like, falls in line around like the feels kind of part of their discography, I guess. But yeah, What Would I Want Sky is just like a really awesome track that's got a really cool switch up halfway through. And this did come with an inner sleeve too that looks pretty much like the cover up, but there it is. Moving right along here, we have MGMT's Congratulations. Yeah, this is a really awesome MGMT album. I remember when this came out, like everybody was on MGMT at the time. And then this record dropped, and I feel like it just kind of divided the fan base and everybody. They weren't really ready for it. It was also, like, critically not really that well received. But yeah, this one's actually, like, I think their best album overall. I really like this one. This isn't that cool, like, scratch and sniff or, like, peel away cover. I wish I had that one. That would be really sick. But this is a reissue, and it is foil stamped. I got number 596, if you can see there. And yeah, it's a really nice, thick reissue over here. You know, I think it's like 150 gram, maybe a 20, it feels 150. But yeah, it's standard black vinyl, really, really nice classic Columbia Records labeling there. But yeah, this is a really solid, solid MGMT record. Like, where did they go? I feel like, you know, they dropped that single a little while back and then just kind of like vanished. Like, I don't know. Here's the inner sleeves. You got one of them. It's got the lyrics on there. And it's got a little scribbly with the MGMT on the back. And then we have another one here that's just got a piece of art on it and it's blank on the back. Next up here, I got Donda. Nah, I'm just kidding. This isn't Donda. This is Shabazz Palace's Black Up. This is an amazing experimental hip-hop LP that they sadly have never really been able to recreate the magic of, in my opinion. But yeah, this was former members of Digable Planets. If you're familiar with them from back in the 90s, also check out this inner sleeve. Cool little red inner sleeve there. And yeah, this standard black vinyl, as you might expect. But yeah, this album is awesome. I mean, the production is so cool. And it's one that you want to have on vinyl too, especially if you have like a nice sound system. Because yeah, there's just like a lot of sound play going on. And it just sounds really great on LP if you can track this down. It also has this like really velvety feel to the inner sleeve. It just feels awesome. Moving right along, I have Talking Heads, Little Creatures. Not my favorite Talking Heads album. One of them that came out later in their discography. This is just one that I needed to have to kind of complete my Talking Heads collection because there was one point in time I was like a completist about certain bands. I love the image of them on the back though. Really colorful, really fun. And here's the vinyl, just standard black. Great labeling though. It's got nice, like, you know, matching of the cover art there, but there's actually some fun tracks on here. I forget which one it is. And there's one on here that really slaps that I'm just kind of, like, forgetting the name of. Perfect World, actually. Yeah, that one. That's a fun one. And this also did come with the original inner sleeve, which I was really stoked about. I think I found this at a local record store for, like, a couple bucks back in the day. So, yeah, it's really nice, really complete. Moving right along into some Death Cab for Cutie. I got the photo album. Now, this was out of print for a very long time. I did not have an original pressing. This was the reissue that happened on Bar Circ, I believe, who did it. Bar Circ. A few years later. And yeah, I don't know, it's a fun Death Cab album. It's not my favorite Death Cab album. I truthfully don't really return to Death Cab as much as I used to. But this one still has some good tracks on it. Coney Island's a great one. And yeah, so here it is. Nice 180 gram thick pressing here on black. And, you know, great labeling. So, really nice pressing overall. I mean, Ben Gibbard and company make sure they put a lot of time and effort into their vinyls, I believe, because they really appreciate the aesthetic. And this did come with some fun inner sleeves as well, or just like kind of like art pieces you could kind of hang up together that has lyrics on the bottom. So, we have all these different ones here. But yeah, really nice reissue. Next up, we're going to be moving into a couple dive records. First one is going to be Is R. This one right here was one of the limited presses that was put up through Captured Tracks. And it has this, like, you know, original artwork that Z. Cole Smith did, I believe, that kind of wraps around as, like, an inner sleeve. It's a big poster as well. And here's the original cover art there. It's got a nice kind of, like, glossy, you know, look to the cover as well. So really nice packaging. This one's a little over the top, though. And you'll see what I mean in a second. It came with a bunch of stuff. So we got a couple inner sleeves that I don't normally store the vinyls in. It came with a big art book as well, so more scribblings from Z when he was probably high, you know, a bunch of that kind of stuff going on here. You get the idea. And then there's like another art book. I don't know if mine just came with two, but you know, there's another one on here. There's even like a miniature art book. I mean, there's just so much stuff that this thing came with. And then we have the vinyls, which are clear. And they're two different colors. This one's got like yellow and white streaks going on in it. This being the A and the B side. And then this is the second LP, which is a clear with like a pink and red kind of smoke swirly thing going on. But yeah, this is a, you know, probably the best dive record. I don't know. They don't really have a ton of material. And moving into my other dive record, which I probably should have started with, but I have Ocean right here. The first album, the debut. And this one's a limited pressing. So this one was a tour exclusive. And it's got this, you know, alternate cover art jacket. They are hand numbered out of 500 there at the silver Sharpie. And it's got all the tour dates on there. But yeah, this one right here, I saw it at a show. I remember I did see them at the Boston show at the Sinclair, which was the first one on the tour. And I picked this up because I didn't own the record. So yeah, I had, you know, inner sleeve right here. They were pretty fun live. They were kind of, they had some like interesting videos playing in the background. It was like Sky Ferreira, like just kind of blowing bubbles with, you know, and just, I don't even know, like rolling around on the ground with a bunch of clothes on. It was weird. Here's the vinyl here, which I think they had like stamped over the original one. Yeah, I don't know. This one's like weird. Or actually, no, it looks like it's a Holograms vinyl that says Dive on it. I think the labeling got messed up on this one. Yeah, it's not even the Dive album, so whatever's going on there, I don't know. Next up, I got King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard, Nonagon Infinity. Yeah, this is a good King Gizzard record, one of their better ones. It's a fun one, and, you know, kind of brings together that, like, hard, fuzzy, classic rock style with, you know, a lot of their psychedelic aesthetics and songwriting tendencies. This one's a fun one, and it's on an infinite loop. Here's the gatefold, which is pretty badass looking, and the vinyl is awesome, like all of their vinyls are. It's a green with black splatter. This was an indie exclusive. I think there's like a ton of presses of this, like all of their records, so don't quote me with how many there are. I don't remember, but I did pick this up at a local record store for a good price, so yeah, it's a fun one. It's Nonagon Infinity. Next up is another King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard record, and that's I Am Your Mind Fuzz. This was the one that pretty much got me started on King Gizzard, and then shortly after they dropped Quarters, which is pretty much still my favorite King Gizzard release to this day. But this one's kind of cool. Yeah, I feel like, you know, the more classic Gizzard sound, and then they kind of trailed off into all different territories. And here's the inner sleeve. Right here, it's got the band, it's got the track listing, all that good stuff. And if I'm remembering correctly, I think this one I ordered through Flightless. I don't even remember, but it's a cool kind of, it looks like glow in the dark with like a, you know, kind of like magenta mist in the middle of it. I think this one glows in the dark, if I'm not mistaken. I have not even really tested that, obviously. And closing out this vinyl update, I have Magic Potions Pink Gum. Now here's like a kind of like a sort of indie rock obscurity, if you will. I believe this band's from Sweden, and it sounds like Mac DeMarco. Yeah, I mean, it's got a lot of Mac DeMarco-isms going on. The vocals are a lot different and, like, weirder sounding. But, yeah, this is not a bad album. It's got a lot of sweet hooks on it and some pretty bummer jams. Here's the inner sleeve, which is rad. It's, like, this really highlighter green, which I like a lot. And the vinyl looks nice, too. I mean, just a white vinyl with the really beautiful pink, magenta-y kind of labeling that looks awesome, matches that cover art. But yeah, this one is definitely one to look up, especially if you're a Mac fan. And like I was saying, I mean, it's got a lot of that kind of like, you know, drunken swaying, kind of groovy feel to it and twanginess. I don't know. Yeah, so that'll do it for this week's vinyl update. I'll be back shortly with another one. Hope everyone is doing well. You know, as always, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like and share. And if you want more content from me, hit that subscribe button. Peace.